Firstly, let me welcome you all to the tutorial videos on Google Colab. In this video, we will be learning on Intro to Pandas. The learning objectives of this video are: 1. Gain an introduction to the data frame and series data structures of the Pandas library. 2. Access and manipulate data within a data frame and series. 3. Import CSV data into a Pandas data frame. 4. Reindex a data frame to shuffle data. We will be doing the coding on Google Colab. On Python stack, first we have to install NumPy, which is low-level data structure, whenever we are using Pandas, which is very popular in data science. Now, let us learn what is Pandas and its features. Pandas is an open-source Python library, providing high-performance, easy-to-use data structures and data analysis tools. The features of Pandas are: 1. High-level data structures, that is data frame. 2. Handling of tabular data and rich time series functionality. 3. Data alignment, missing data-friendly statistics, group by, merge and join methods. 4. Freely draw on NumPy and SciPy functions to manipulate them. Now, let us learn the basic concepts of Pandas. We can import the Pandas API and print the API version using the code given. Let us type the code in Google Colab and print the Pandas API to confirm it. Then click on the play button to run the code, and as we can see, the Pandas API is printed. The primary data structures in Pandas are implemented as two classes: 1. Data frame, which you can imagine as a relational data table with rows and named columns. 2. Series, which is a single column. A data frame contains one or more series and a name for each series. The data frame is a commonly used as abstraction for data manipulation. One way to create a series is to construct a series object. For example, let us do it in Google Colab. We can print the names in a column. Then click on the play button to run the code, and as we can see, the names are printed in a column with indexes. DataFrame objects can be created by passing a dict mapping string column names to their respective series. If the series don't match in length, missing values are filled with special, not available or not a number values. Pandas aims to be flexible with regard to handling missing data. We can print the string column names to their respective series through creating data frame objects. Let us do it in Google Colab. For example, firstly, let us print the city names, then followed by population with some numbers in proper indexes and strings, and print the data frame with string column names with their respective series. Then click on the play button to run the code, and as you can see, we get the string column names printed with their respective series and data frame objects. But most of the time, we load an entire file into a data frame. Now in Google Colab, let us load a file with California housing data. Let us type the code for that. Then, click on the play button to run the code to load the data and create feature definitions. Then let us type dataframe.describe function, which will show us interesting statistics about a data frame. Again, type another useful function, that is, dataframe.head, which displays the first few records of a data frame. Another powerful feature of Pandas is graphing. Now, let us type the function dataframe.hist, which lets us quickly study the distribution of values in a column. Now, let us learn how to access data frame data. We can access data frame data using familiar Python dict or list operations. Let us type the code for that in Google Colab. Then, click on the play button to run the code, and as you can see, we get access to the data frame data, which prints the indexes 0 and 1, as shown in the code given. In addition, Pandas provides an extremely rich API for advanced indexing and selection that is too extensive to be covered here. Now, let us learn how to manipulate data. We can apply Python's basic arithmetic operations to the series. So, let us do it in Google Colab. For example, let us divide the population that we have already accessed from the data frame data by 1000. We will get the manipulated data. Pandas series can be used as arguments to most NumPy functions. Then type which will give us the logarithm value of data frame data. For more complex single column transformations, we can use series.apply. Series.apply accepts as an argument a lambda function, which is applied to each value. For example, let us type the code in Google Colab. We can create a new series that indicates whether population is over 1 million. Modifying data frames is also straightforward. For example, let us type the code in Google Colab, which adds two series to an existing data frame. Lastly, let us do some exercises. First one, modify the cities table by adding a new Boolean column that is true if and only if both of the following are true. 1. The city is named after a saint. 2. The city has an area greater than 50 square miles. Let us solve this problem in Google Colab. By default, at construction, Pandas assigns index values that reflect the ordering of the source data. Once created, the index values are stable, that is, they do not change when data is reordered. Call DataFrame.reindex to manually reorder the rows. For example, let us do it in Google Colab, type the code. This gives us the same effect as sorting by city name. Reindexing is a great way to shuffle a data frame. NumPy's random.permutation function, which shuffles its values in place. Calling reindex with this shuffled array causes the data frame rows to be shuffled in the same way. The reindex method allows index values that are not in the original data frame's index values. If your reindex input array includes values not in the original data frame index values, reindex will add new rows for these missing indices and populate all corresponding columns with not a number values. This behavior is desirable because indexes are often strings pulled from the actual data.